All right, Corey, your third fight week for Bellator. We ask you, you know, when you sign with Bellator, what do you think it's going to be like? You know, and you voiced optimism. You said you think this is the right move. Now that you're here, you're in the middle of it, you've had the reps in. Do you think this was definitely the right move for you? You're enjoying your time here?
I don't think it was the right move. I know it was the right move. You know, like I said, it's been nothing but a pleasure working with everyone here. I just can't wait to continue this relationship.
Yeah, for sure. And I guess, what do you think the biggest differences are here compared to the UFC? Is it like, you know, better compensation? Is it just the fight week vibe? What is it for you that makes you enjoy your time here?
I mean, the one thing I can't compare is the fight week vibe because of COVID. You know, fight weeks have been a little different. But everything other than that, it's been great, you know? The employees at the UFC were always great to work with. The blue shirts, everybody there was amazing. And here, it's the same thing. But the higher ups, like, we need to get information to you. You need questions, you gotta ask somebody. As for UFC, sometimes it's kind of tough to get a hold of people. As here, I can message Scott Coker, I can message Mike Kogan, Kerry, Jane, somebody, they text me back within 2-3 minutes. And if they don't know the answer, they're gonna text somebody who's gonna text me immediately or call me with the answer. And that makes it a lot easier as a fighter. Like, I'm in campus, a lot of things I'm already gotta worry about. So if I got a question, they can get the answer without spending so much time trying to figure it out. That's a big help for me, and I think that along with the compensation and everything else, but that right there is the biggest takeaway for me that makes it so much easier for me to be a fighter and make it easier for me to work with because they're so much easier to work with.
Yeah, for sure, and obviously you still plenty of big fights here for you. You're in the midst of the tournament. How are you feeling coming into this one against your buddy Ryan Bader? Camp went well, everything's going smooth?
Man, this is probably one of the best camps, best weight cut so far. I mean, I did a lot of things different. I mean, I've always been good with my diet. I've always been great with my training. But this time, I brought in a lot of heavy hitters. Like, I wrestled with the Olympic champ, Jaden Cox. I wrestled with Nate Jackson, number one 83-kilogram wrestler in the world. Brought in Jimmy Lawson, a two-time D1 All-American heavyweight wrestler, MMA fighter. He's a heavyweight. He's bigger than me. Guys like that can actually beat me up. You know, I always got great partners like Rex Harris and Carl Roberson. We got this kid CJ, Chris Hayes. We got these guys, young guys, that's hungry and can push the pace. When you get somebody in there that's actually bigger than you, stronger than you, can actually throw you around and take you down because they're bigger, you know, that's an impact. And it's either going to make you or it's going to break you. And there's been times where it's like, damn, I don't want to go with this big no more. But every time I would get down and text him, like, yo, you coming back tomorrow, right? Are you coming back for the next one? Thank you. I need you all camp. And that is what makes me, that's going to take me to this next spot in this fight.
And I know you and Ryan, you know, you've had some little exchanges here and there in the media just in terms of practice, right? It's like Allen Iverson, practice, practice, practice being brought up. Every time we brought it up with him, he said, well, you know, I don't know why Corey's bringing that up. It's practice. So for you, I guess, how would you respond to that? Is it like a mental edge? You feel like you know what went down in that gym, so you're kind of carrying that into this fight?
The main thing is, like, he's getting older and I just got to my prime. You remember what I did when I first got in. You remember how good I was then. I mean, his coaches, both times I went out, his old coach said we couldn't call you out anymore when he was in the UFC because you were too good and there was a possibility that we might fight you. That was my first year in the UFC. 3 years later when I came out, his coach had me leave. I'm going to the airport. Like, brother, you sure you can't stay? You're really good. We don't have anybody that can go with him like that. We would love if you can come back and help more. So I got to get back to my own camp. Now, if I did that in my first 3 years of fighting, and 8 years later, I've made it to the top of the division, he knows I've only gotten better. You know I was good then. What, you think I went down? No, he knows what it's going to be like when I get in the cage. He said it when he commentated my fight. We all know Corey was a workhorse. That's why we call him overtime. But the only thing he don't have is his right-hand power. So you depend on one thing against my whole arsenal. That's cool.
And I think I heard you just mention it there. Maybe you can clarify. Do you feel like he's regressed a little bit? Like you said, you were in your prime and that you know, he's kind of on the decline a little bit. Is that what you just mentioned?
I'm not saying so much of a decline, like, oh, you suck now. But it's things you lose as you get older, you know? You don't get more athletic as you get older. Your bones get brittle. You can't do the same thing. Granted, my boy Rex, I know he would say different. He about 38 and look like a chiseled stone over here. But things that get better, you get stronger, you get wiser. You can sometimes get a little faster. But when you've been in sport as long as he has and the battles he's been through and the fights he's had and the way he trains, I mean, we all train top, it's kind of hard to get more explosive. You just get smarter with what you do. You get wiser. You're more savvy as a veteran. So I'm not saying he's declining, but some of the things he used to do phenomenal, he doesn't do as great. But the things that he didn't do as well, he does better in his later years.
And you obviously said you had a very wrestle-heavy camp, talking about Jimmy Lawson and some of the other, you know, Olympians and stuff that you brought in. Do you expect him that to be his game plan, that he's going to try to drag you down, or do you think that he'll try to test his striking before he resorts there?
To be honest, I think he's going to try to move around a little bit. You know, he he knows wrestling-wise, it's not going to be like a one-sided fight like most of his fights. So he knows I can wrestle as well. And he knows my cardio. So he also knows wrestling is a very taxing thing on your cardio. So I don't think he's going to push that early. He's going to move around. Hopefully I'll overstep, make a mistake, and he can hit me with his hard jab or an overhand right with a big left hook. Or if I overstep, he'll grab a single leg and try to get me to the cage to wear me down. But I'm prepared for anything. Whatever he's ready for, he want to go to the ground, he want to strike, I can do it all. I box with undefeated pro boxers all camp. I wrestle with the Olympic champ. I've brought the best of the best from around the world that I can find and push myself in every aspect. So I'm ready wherever we go.
And we know who you got in the co-main event, but who do you have in the main event? Who are you taking between Vadim Nemkov and Julius Anglicus?
I'm going to go with Nemkov. You know, like I said all the time, I like Julius. He's young. He's sharp. I've been to the camp in St. Charles, MMA. I love everything their coach is doing. And like I said, the kid's young, and I've been watching since he came in. He's really good, really, really good. But the only thing I say is, with 2 weeks' notice, I just feel it's kind of hard to prepare, you know. But Nemkov is just somebody I watch as well. He's very excited. He's good. He's young, and he's fast. So at the end, I'm just going to give that edge that way. But like I said, also, it's comparing the Rumble and Julius. Julius and Rumble, they both got really good striking, so he can catch him at any time. But all around edge, I have to say Nemkov because of what he's been through.
And I respect you sticking with your guns, even though the present company's sitting out in the hallway there, right there. But last prediction for you. You were one of the few guys that's been in the cage both with Glover Teixeira and Jan Blachowicz. They fight at the end of this month. Are you leaning one way or another in that fight?
To be honest, they're both great opponents. I've lost to Jan. I'm 1-1 with him, but I've beat Glover. At the end of the day, like I said, when I fought Glover in the third round, the one thing he had was that I'm still here. That's why when I fought John the first time in the third round, I looked at him and he was done. And I feel that right there is going to give Glover the victory, because even if John catches him early but doesn't put him away, as the fight goes on, we all know Glover going to get that finish.
Awesome, Corey. Really looking forward to the fight on Saturday, and the best of luck, man.
Thank you.